Hi guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. As requested for today's video, I'm going to be doing three new looks with the Pat Mcgrath Labs Mothership Mega Celestial Odyssey palette. This is the newest palette to have come out in her holiday 2021 collection. If you missed it, I did review this a couple days ago, so definitely check that out. I swatch all the shades individually, and then I also create a really fun and beautiful look that's definitely worth checking out in addition to today's video. And I just want this video to inspire you. Once you guys start getting yours in the mail, maybe put some ideas of some color combinations that you could create in your head. If you recreate any of the looks that I show you for today, or even if you're just inspired by the looks, make sure you tag me on Instagram. I love to see when you guys recreate my looks. So I create a smoky eye today, I create a more natural pinky eye, and then of course I create this fun eye right here. So if you want to see that, then just keep watching. Starting off with Sunrose Amber, I'm going to apply this all over the crease. I am using an Alamar Cosmetics crease brush with this. I'm creating a really smoky, glittery eye, so I would suggest before you do this to powder underneath or to do your face makeup after. When I film tutorial videos, I just can't do them in that order, just because of the nature of the video, but if you're doing this at home, don't do this with face makeup on. I don't even have powder on, like I am risking it. So pretty much this look is going to be really black and smoky, so just get ready. We are then going into Nocturne. This is a Rephr 14 brush, and I'm just going to put this all along the crease. You can see I focused the color in the outer corner, but actually for this look, I want it to go across the whole crease. Doesn't matter where the darkest point is because the whole lid is going to be dark, so just build this transition area. So we are really gonna just go in. I'm taking Noir Moon and I'm putting this all over the lid. I'm kind of nervous about this. So since I have face makeup on, I'm just gonna put a tissue underneath to hopefully stop some fallout here. And I'm gonna use my finger, just pat this all over my lid. You can also reduce fallout by tilting your head back. Obviously that makes it difficult for you guys to see, so bear with me as I make sure all of this is even. This has a ton of pigment, you guys. And I barely got any fallout on my tissue. Wow, stunning. Okay, we do need to blend, obviously. So I'm gonna put this back on and we're gonna work these edges to create a seamless blend. Don't blend too high. You don't wanna look like you have a black eye. You wanna keep that transition really, really blended. I'm gonna wipe my brush to make sure the color doesn't get carried too high as we work on the blend. I'm sorry, I know I'm definitely off focus a little bit, but I just wanna make sure I don't mess up my face makeup. So you see how we were able to create a really great blend. I'm gonna go in with a little bit more of Noir Moon on my finger, and I'm just gonna spruce up the eyelid. I didn't use anything besides a concealer as an eyeshadow base, so I don't have any glitter glue or anything on my lid, and you can see the glitter is staying and it looks really gorgeous and blended. Okay, let me clean off my brush. I'm going to put the matte brown colors on my lower lash line just to create this base color, but I'm gonna put more black on, so just get ready. This look is only using just a few eyeshadows. We just have the matte colors down. Taking a Morphe pencil brush, I'm going back in with the black. Tap off your brush to reduce the mess. Here we go. For the final step, I'm just doing the inner corner pop. You can do whatever shade you want. You can do a bright teal. I'm gonna go for Citrine Envy, but any of these shades, the gold, would be so fun. But y'all know I'm obsessed with this green, so it's gonna look amazing on the inner corner. This is my favorite shade in the entire palette, and it's gonna take everything in me not to use this in every single look today. Okay, so I'm gonna do black liner all along my lash line and my waterline and heavy lashes, and I will show you the final look. Okay, so here is the final look with lashes. I really love it, and I love how you can really change the inner corner to whatever color that you like. The sparkles, you can't really pick them up on camera, but this Noir shade is so beautiful. The sparkles are different shades. There's like blue and green sparkles in there. This look is so fun. This shade is such good quality to be able to hold on to the glitters without fallout and have the opacity. This is one of my favorite shades in the palette, honestly, just because of how good it is. If you watch my original review, the biggest critique I had about this palette was I wish there was more colors in the matte shades, because there's only two pink matte shades and then two brown matte shades, and those are great basic starter colors, but I just wish there was more because mattes can transform the look. But anyways, enough jibber jabbering. I want to do something a little bit more wearable on this eye, because one of the selling points of this palette is that it actually is quite wearable. You also have the ability to create very dramatic looks, but you also can create really, really wearable looks. We're going to start off with Lotus Luxe. This is a BK202, and I'm just putting this all over the crease. It's Pat McGrath. Don't be scared to use shimmers as crease colors. You can see that this definitely does have a little bit of glitters, but honestly, I think it looks really good in the crease. It's not maybe as satin as I would want a shade in the crease to be if it has a little bit of shimmer to it, but it's gonna work just fine as the base color for this look. I don't know how wearable this look is gonna be, just being honest with y'all now that I'm looking. We are going to go into Sunset Saturn right here using a Rephr number 14 brush. And this is going to mattify the look a little bit in the outer corner. The look is taking me to this color, so it's asking for this shade. And this really deepens everything. Sonia G Builder Brush, and we're going into Bronze Eclipse. And I'm going to put this right next to the outer corner. So it's not going to go all the way towards the back of the eye, but this is building into more of a bronzed kind of look. And whatever's left over on my brush, I'm just going to put it all over my lid, but I want the heaviest concentration right here. So I haven't used this shade on my eyes yet, so I really wanted to. This is Bronze Nova. Look at that. Okay, I'm gonna put this all along my lid, and this is the perfect color for the look because it's a bronzy brown shade, but it has those pink reflex to pull in the pinky tones. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh my gosh, I love it. This is more wearable now. I like the direction that it's going. So I'm gonna go back to the original crease color that we used. We're gonna put this along the lower lash line. We're gonna take some of Bronze Eclipse again. This is going to define the outer corner out here. We are going to brighten up down there with some of Galactic Glow. This particular shade has a ton of dimension and glitters. It's going to brighten up the eye, as you can see. We're going to use Heavenly Body as our inner corner color right here. And then don't forget below the brow bone. This is a more wearable, bronzy, pink kind of look. I'm going to put liner and lashes on, and you will see how it pulls together. So here is the final look with lashes. I was worried that this look was going to be boring for you guys, but honestly, it is so pretty. I highly recommend you try this out if you're looking for something more wearable with this palette. This isn't as wearable as the palette can go. Obviously, you can use the matte browns and like the inner corner color all over the lid. That would be really natural and pretty, but this is, oh my gosh, this just will bring out the color of your eyes. It's not too much. I love this look. I'm surprised how much I like it. I love both of these looks that I've done so far. Let's move over to the third and final look. All right, let's get into the last and final look. I'm obsessed with it. When we get lashes on, it's gonna look so good. So we are gonna start off with this shade here. The shade name is Electric. And I'm not worried too much about pigment poking through. Honestly, I think I took too much on my crease brush. I really just want to create a shadow here. I actually put more on this eye than I did on my other eye, but this is just to create a base for blending. Not too much pink shows through the look, so don't even worry about the shade too much. Sonia G Builder, and we're taking Palladium. This is kind of like a pewter silver shade, and I'm going to apply this right in the inner third of the lid. We are going to brighten it up with another shade in a few moments. I like this kind of grayish undertone that's going to bleed into the teal beautifully. Using my finger, we're going to go into the ever so gorgeous Nirvana. One of the selling points of this palette, am I right? I'm going to pop this on the rest of my eyelid, going all the way out to the outer corner, just like this. This has a lot of pigment, you guys. Gonna take that builder brush and we're gonna work on blending the blue together. It's like this, so it's a really natural kind of fade. And I did end up actually wanting to brighten up the inner corner. So we are going to go right here into Galactic Glow. This is a lot brighter, so we're gonna utilize that as our inner corner color as well as our outer corner color. And I'm almost going over Palladium just a little bit because you see how that re-brightens everything. And then I'm going to work on blending the edges of shimmers. Just do it softly. We're going to work on this very, very slowly. I can't believe how much I love this Noir Moon shade. We're going to use this again. I'm just using a Morphe eyeshadow brush. See, again, to protect the face makeup, I'm just going to put it underneath. And I'm going to focus this in the outer corner right on top of the teal. This is mostly just to smoke everything, make it look a little bit more dramatic. But I just also really love the sparkles that this color brings to the eye and the extra dimension that it's going to bring. And then again, work on blending. I'm going to go into a little bit of the blue. This is the star of the show, so we really do want it to pop. I'm using a ColourPop pencil brush, and we are going into Gold Galaxy. Really shocking how super pigmented this gold is. So just be prepared. On this eye, I dug way too much into the gold and got too much color, believe it or not. So I'm slowly building it on this eye. I love the gold and the teal contrast. And then mostly because I haven't yet used this shade yet from this palette, let's go into Corrupt Copper. And I'm going to put this right in the outer corner of the lower lash line. And you can see this one is also extremely pigmented. And I'm almost flicking the shade up a little bit, just like that. Next up, I'm taking some of Noir Moon on an angled brush. We're just going to work on the cut and almost like wing out the eyes. It's not a winged liner, but it's really just to bring the eyes out and to widen them, just like that. And I'm also gonna take it on the angled brush, kind of put it really close to the lash line. So you can see I'm using a really dense, precise brush, and I'm just putting it right out here to bring the two sides together. Okay, I'm gonna do liner and lashes, and you will see the whole look pulled together. Here is the third and final look in today's video using the Celestial Odyssey palette from Pat McGrath. What do you guys think? I love this one. This one is so pretty. I love the gold with the teal. It's very interesting. Let me know what your favorite look was. Was it number one? Was it number two? Was it number three? The exciting thing about this palette is there is like a billion other combinations that I can see myself creating. I don't know. This palette makes me feel really creative. I see so many different looks that I want to do, and I know when my friends start getting their videos up, they're gonna create some insane looks as well. Like, I've only done three today, and I wish my eyes weren't so sensitive so that I could do more, because there's so much more that I can see doing. So anyway, these three looks, I still love the palette just as much as I did in the original review. We still do not have a dud shade in here now that I've played with more of the shadows, and the looks are really fun, and I am having a good time with this one. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Thank you so much to those of you who have subscribed to me and of course have liked this video. It helps me so much, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.